Dear friends and viewers, Namaste. Welcome back to KNS Biochemistry channel. In this video session, we are going to see about one of the area of biomedical applications of nanomaterials. It is nothing but polymer micelles as drug carriers. These PMs, that is polymer micelles, are used to carry the drug molecules to the target cells. So in this session, we are going to see about the polymer micelle structures, the different types of polymer micelle structures used for drug delivery. And then we are going to see about advantages of using PMs, that's polymer micelle structures, as a drug carriers. Then finally we are going to see about the applications of polymer micelle structures, especially they are applied in the field of nanotechnology for drug loading and release into the target. So let us start the session now. Come along with me.
Polymer micelles, that is the polymer micelle structures. So you can see a structure is here. This is one of the polymer micelle structure. So in this session we are going to see about polymer micelle structures. What are these polymeric micelles? They are called PMs, polymeric micelles. They are nano carriers that are formed by spontaneous arrangement of amphiphilic block copolymers. Amphiphilic means water loving. Amphiphilic block copolymers in aqueous solutions. These nanoparticles have a hydrophobic core. A core is there that is hydrophobic in nature, and hydrophilic shell architecture. The outer shell is hydrophilic in nature, water loving in nature. Hydrophilic shell architecture that facilitates the loading of hydrophobic drugs into the core. The drug will be loaded into the core, and these are all called PMs, polymeric micelles. Here you can see the structure of one polymeric micelle. So this is hydrophobic core at the center, and that is surrounded by hydrophilic outer ring. It is looking like that is crownling. That is why it is called hydrophilic corona. Even if you take coronavirus, it will be having outer spikes like this. That is why it got the name coronavirus. So this is hydrophilic corona. So these polymeric micelles are formed from self aggregation of amphibilic block or graft copolymers with the hydrophobic part of the polymer on the inner side. That inner side, that is called core region, and hydrophilic on the outer side, that is called outer shell, that is hydrophilic corona. This portion, hydrophilic corona, this is hydrophobic core region. In drug delivery, these PMs are classified under the nano carriers. So as far as this drug delivery is concerned, what is the role of these PMs? They are acting as nano carriers. They are going to carry the drug, but they are nano level shaped, these carriers. So they are called as nano carriers. A polymeric micelle usually consists of several hundred block copolymers and has a diameter of at about 20 to 50 nanometer. 20 to 50, maximum 50 nanometer is the size, diameter size. So here you can see the amphibolic block core polymers. These are all the core polymers used, and they are going to assemble, that is by self-assembly. It happens in an aqueous media above CM the cell membrane. And you see that this is a drug. This sky blue is hydrophobic drug. This is the hydrophilic block. This is the black color rod is hydrophobic block. So using hydrophobic block, inner core is formed. Using hydrophilic block, hydrophilic corona is formed. It happens self-assembly way, and the drug is kept inside the core. So this is the basic structure of a polymeric micelle. These self-assembled supramolecular core cell structure. So this is the core cell structure. It's a polymeric micelle core cell structure. The outer layer is there. And you said this core is a dense region. You see that here only density is high because the drug is there. Core is a dense region consisting of the hydrophobic part of the amphibolic polymer. So this is the outer shell is the amphibolic polymer, but the core is hydrophobic polymer. So this core serves as a reservoir for drugs. So this is the cavity or the reservoir in which the drugs are placed. So there is a reservoir for drugs with low aqueous solubility, because here it is hydrophobic in nature, so aqueous solubility is less. The outer shell, see that this is the shell, outer shell, this is the core, outer shell, this is a singly loaded polymeric micelle. So this is outer shell, and you see that the green color one is a PTX, and the violet color, this is another drug, 17AH. These are all the drug molecules. The yellow is REAP, another drug. And this is the polymer, polyethylene glycol, PLA polymer. So the shell, outer shell, consisting of hydrophilic portions of the copolymer. The morphology of the micelles is the hydrophilic hydrophobic balance. Hydrophilic outer side, hydrophobic inside, both are equally balanced. So hydrophilic hydrophobic balance of the block copolymer defined by the hydrophilic volume fraction, that is approximately 45% form of this PM is having hydrophilic volume fraction. So these block copolymers, how are you going to get these copolymers to in order to synthesize PM, that is polymeric micelles? So advances in block copolymer synthesis have led to polymeric micelles that may serve as nanoscopic drug carriers, that is nano drug carriers. So for the drug delivery, micelles were prepared from biocompatible and biodegradable black copolymers. So the black copolymers are used here are biodegradable one. Otherwise, when it goes inside the body, if it becomes non-biodegradable, it will become toxic to the body. So it must be biocompatible and biodegradable. The body should accept it, that is biocompatible form. The polymeric micelles display functional groups on their surfaces for attachment of pilot molecules. So the researchers are establishing chemical as well as physical routes of loading the drugs into these polymeric micelles. How to load the drug into the polymeric micelle core? So there are some routes, some ways, methods are there. So notably, polymeric micelles solubilize hydrophobic drugs suffering from poor water solubility. If your drug is hydrophobic in nature, suffering poor this poor water solubility, these PMs will solubilize them. The recent study suggests that polymeric micelles may have solid-like cores at the center. Thus, they may remain intact for long durations under sink conditions and may also slowly release the drugs to the target. So they may have solid like cores, that is a center core. So these cores, solid like cores, they may remain intact for long duration under sink conditions, and this is that they are going to release the drug slowly for a long period. So the mechanistically polymeric micelles, PMs, may act as drug carriers. That is why they are used as drug carriers, by circumventing host defenses, circulating for prolonged periods, and extravasating from the vascular system, preferentially delivering the drug to solid tumors, especially to tumors. So what are all the types of polymeric micelles? So far we have seen the basic structure of a PM. Then we have different types of polymeric micelles. We are going to see them one by one. On the basis of the type of intramolecular forces governing the segregation of the core segment from the aqueous environment, different polymeric micelles are formed. Number one, hydrophobic interaction. Through hydrophobic interaction, and you are getting some PMs. These are conventional micelles formed by hydrophobic interaction. Next one is polyion complex micelles. These are formed by electrostatic interactions. Third one is formed by metal complexation. These are non-covalently connected, because it is connected through metals, non-covalently connected polymeric micelles. So conventional micelles, polyion complex micelles, then non-covalently connected polymeric micelles. Three types of PMs. And this is not the structure of a micelle, but the micelles are formed from this basic structure only. So this is a typical schematic structure of a liposome. Liposome, you know that liposome is nothing but it's a lipid bilayer, plasma membrane layer that covers inner core. Inside the core, you will be having the drug. So here you see that hydrophobic drugs are trapped here in the hydrophobic region of the lipid bilayer. Then hydrophilic drugs are taken inside the core, because here you have hydrophilic glycerol moiety. So hydrophilic drugs naturally interact here only in the core region. And the target ligand is here on the surface. This is the target ligand. The target ligand is here, this ligand. So it will go and bind with the target, and the drug will be released. This is a basic structure of a liposome. And from this basic structure only, micelles came from liposome. Liposomes are having lipid bilayer. Micelles are not having lipid layer. They will be having single layer. That is the difference. You can see the basic schematic structure of polymersomes. Polymersomes based on that. This is polymersome. It is a somewhat advanced structure of the liposome. And these are all polymersomes, but they are not. These are not liposome. I mean polymeric micelles. So the structure A is a di-block polymersome. Di-block. You see that it is having two copolymers joined together and forms a structure. Here this is hydrophobic drug, it is there in the hydrophobic lipid bilayer. Hydrophilic drug is at the center. It is something like liposome. So di-block copolymer is used here. And the B is tri-block copolymer. Three copolymers are going to construct this polymer soaps. So 1, 2, 3. So that is why this is a tri-polymer block, this is di-block copolymer. And these two structures, liposomes and these two structures, are the basic structures for forming a micelle, that is polymeric micelle. And this is schematic structures of polymeric micelles. This is the polymeric micelle actually. The structure A, you can see that this is having the center, that central core, and this hydrophobic drugs are placed at the center core. Hydrophilic drugs here, in this case, hydrophilic drugs are placed here. So A is typical micelle in a polar solvent. In a polar solvent, if a micelle is formed, see that you will be getting this region. This is hydrophilic region outside, hydrophobic inside. So hydrophobic drugs will be trapped inside. Second one is reversal of this polymer micelle. So that is called reverse micelle. What is this reverse micelle? This micelle is formed in a non-polar solvent. Non-polar solvent like organic solvent. So where you see that hydrophobic region will be outside. Hydrophilic will be at the center. It is like liposome. And you see that your hydrophilic drug is trapped inside. And this is the target, targeting ligand. This is there on the surface. So this is a liposome, this is a reverse liposome. I mean reverse micelle. This is a typical micelle and this is reverse micelle. So polymer micelle structures. Polymer micelle structures, how are you going to synthesis these polymer micelle structures? So we are going to see the methods. The methods used for synthesis of polymer micelles. The first method used is self-assembled micelles. That is structure, that is synthesis of polymer micelles by self-assembly, by themselves. Here you can see that self-assembly of block copolymer micelles. So here we are going to see, use hydrophobic block, this black color, and this is hydrophilic black. And that single polymer chains, these are all single polymer chains. Single polymer chains, and they have one hydrophobic block and hydrophilic block. So this is a single polymer chain is called unimers. Like monomer, it is unimer. Single polymer chain. So it is called unimers. These unimers at a temperature, a favorable temperature, presence of all these chemicals, you see that they are polymerized. And you'll get hydrophobic shell outside, hydrophobic shell outside, and there is hydrophobic shell, core at the center, hydrophobic core at the center, hydrophilic shell outside. That is water loving area outside, water hating area inside. Hydrophobic core, hydrophilic shell. So this is a polymeric micelle. So the self-assembled polymer micelles are created from amphibolic polymers that spontaneously form nano-sized aggregates when the individual polymer chains, that is unimers, are directly dissolved in an aqueous solution. That is, this is called dissolution method. In an aqueous solution above a threshold concentration. What is that threshold concentration? The critical micelle concentration. That is called CMC. So in critical micelle concentration, you see that it will be polymerized. And the solution temperature is called critical micelle temperature. So in that CMT, that temperature and that critical micelle concentration only, this polymerization happens and polymeric micelles are self-assembled. Self-assembled polymeric micelle formation. So as a result of rapid development of novel nanotechnology derived materials, a new generation of polymer therapeutics has emerged, which uses materials and devices of nanoscale size for the delivery of drugs, genes and imaging molecules. So these materials include polymer micelles, that is these polymer micelles formed by self-assembly. These polymer DNA complexes, polymer micelles, polymer DNA complexes are otherwise called as polyplexes, liposomes and other nanostructured materials for medical use that are collectively called nanomedicines. Compared to first generation polymer therapeutics, the new generation nanomedicines are more advanced. They entrap small drugs or biopharmaceutical agents such as therapeutic proteins and DNA, and they can be designed to trigger the release of these agents at the target site. Many nanomedicines are constructed using self-assembly principles such as spontaneous formation of micelles or interpoly electrolyte complexes driven by diverse molecular interactions like hydrophobic or electrostatic interactions. So these polymeric micelles among as an important example of the new generation of nanomedicines, which perhaps is also among most advanced toward clinical applications and diagnostics and treatment of human diseases. So here you can see that I told you that it is temperature, that is CNT, critical temperature. So in that temperature only these molecules are formed. So these amphibolic polymers, that is unimers, with very low water solubility can alternatively be dissolved in a volatile organic solvent. That is, in organic solvent you are going to dissolve them, then dialyzed against an aqueous buffer, that is called the dialysis method. So these amphibolic dye block, that is dye block material, hydrophilic and hydrophobic, or tri-block material, hydrophilic, hydrophobic and again hydrophilic, copolymers are most commonly used to prepare self-assembled polymer micelles for drug delivery, although the use of graft copolymers has been reported. So for drug delivery purposes, the individual unimers used here are designed to be biodegradable, because when it is go to the body, it should not cause any toxic effects. So that is why they must be biodegradable. And or they have a low enough molecular mass. That is, molecular mass is that it is less than 40 kilodaltons to be eliminated by renal clearance in order to avoid polymer buildup within the body that can potentially lead to toxicity. The most developed amphibolic block copolymers assemble into spherical core shell micelles approximately 10 to 18 nanometer in diameter that consists of a hydrophobic core for drug loading and a hydrophilic shell that acts as a physical barrier or a steric barrier to both micelle aggregation in solution and to protein binding and opsonization during systemic administration. Here you can see that micelle, polymer micelle structure formation. This is self-assembled method. No self-assembly means you see that homopolymer cannot assemble. But if you take two polymers, you'll get a di-block copolymer. They can go for self-assemble. You'll get a self-assembled micelle like this. Tri-block copolymer, again you'll get a self-assembled PM. Graft copolymer, this is graft copolymer, you will get a self-assembled PM. And this is charged copolymer, two charges joined together and it forms polymer micelle structures. And this is the other method, covalently assembled formation of PM, that is unimolecular micelles are formed. So here see that this is hydrophilic block and this is hydrophobic block, this is cationic block, anionic block. Using that star-like formation is formed by covalent attachment, or dendritic assembly by covalent attachment. The most common hydrophilic block used to form the hydrophilic shell is the FDA-approved excipient polyethylene glycol, PEG is used as a hydrophilic shell, or polyethylene oxide, PEO or PEG. So these two, PEG and PEO, consist of the same repeating monomer unit, that is CH2CH2O. This is the single unit. This is repeated several times. And may have different terminal end groups depending upon the synthesis procedure. So here the next method used to synthesis PMs, polymeric micelle, is unimolecular method, unimolecular micelles formation. These unimolecular micelles are topologically similar to self-assembled micelles. It is similar to that self-assembled micelles, but consist of single polymer molecules, only one polymer molecules with covalently linked amphiphile chains. For example, copolymers with star-like, the previous structure we have seen, that is called unimolecular micelles. Copolymers with star-like structure or dendritic architecture, depending on their structure and composition, can either aggregate into multimolecular micelles or exist as unimolecular micelles. Dendrimers are widely used as building blocks to prepare unimolecular micelles because they are highly branched. They have well-defined globular shape and controlled surface functionality. For example, unimolecular micelles, I have shown you in the previous star-like dendritic structure, were prepared by coupling dendritic hypercores of different generations with the polyethylene glycol oxides, that is PEO chains. The dendritic cores can entrap various drug molecules. However, due to the structural limitations involved in the synthesis of dendrimers of higher generation and relatively compact structure of the dendrimers The loading capacity of these dendrimer is very, very essential. So capacity of such micelles is very important, and it is limited also. So thus, to increase the loading capacity of these dendrimers core, it can be modified with a hydrophobic block followed by attachment of PEO chains. For example, recently synthesized an amphiphilic 16-arm star polymer with a polyamidoamine dendrimer core and arms composed of inner lipophilic poly, that is epsilon poly caprolactone polymer block and outer PEO block. These unimolecular micelles were shown to encapsulate a hydrophobic drug, etoposide, with high loading capacity. Multi-arm star-like block copolymers represent another type of unimolecular micelles. Star polymers are generally synthesized by either the arm-first or core-first methods. In the arm-first method, non-monofunctional living linear macromolecules are synthesized and then cross-linked either through propagation using a bifunctional co-monomer or by adding a multifunctional terminating agent to connect precise number of arms to one center. Conversely, in the core-first method, polymer chains are grown from a multifunctional initiator. One of the first reported examples for unimolecular micelles suitable for any type of drug delivery was a 3-arm star polymer composed of mucicic acid. 3-arm star. It is made up of mucicic acid substituted with the fatty acids as a lipophilic inner block and PEO as the hydrophilic outer block. These polymers were directly dispersible in aqueous solution and formed unimolecular micelles. The size and solubilizing capacity of the micelles was varied by changing the ratio of the hydrophilic and lipophilic moieties. In addition, star copolymers with the polyelectrolyte arms can be prepared to develop pH-sensitive unimolecular micelles.
Dear friends, so in this session, we have seen about the structure of polymicelles, that is PMs, then different types of polymicelles. Then we have seen the advantages of using polymicelles for carrying a nanodrug to the target site. Then finally we have seen the applications of these PMs, especially in the transportation of drug, the drug loading and drug release to the target cells. With that, I'm going to stop this session. I'll be coming back to you in another session. Until then, it is a bye from KNS Biochemistry. Thank you very much. Namaskar.